Hey, my name is Christian from BitBranding, and today we're going to create some discount codes in Shopify. Let's get into it. So the first thing you want to do is go to the left-hand menu and click on discounts. Now there are two main types of discounts. We have the regular discount codes, and then we have automated discounts. I'm actually gonna go through the process here, and I'm also gonna give you some examples of what you can do with the regular discount codes and the automatic ones. So let's create a discount code here by clicking on that big purple button. All right, and then I'm gonna just kind of walk you through each of these steps and what you can do. The first thing that it will prompt you is to create a discount code. This discount code is what customers will enter when they are ready to check out. So good rule of thumb is to do in all caps, maybe summer, and let's say that it's a 10% discount, maybe summer 10, and that's it. You can also generate a code. Now, when you click on generate code, it's gonna give you a bunch of different letters, numbers, and it's kind of hard to keep track of, and it's hard for the customers to learn that if you're trying to promote this discount code. Now over here on the right hand side, you'll see a summary. So as you select things over here, it will automatically show you the summary on the right hand side. So the first thing you can do is types, right? So you have percentage, you have a fixed amount, you have free shipping, and you also have the option to, which is kind of new, buy X, you can get Y. So for buy X, get Y, you could do maybe, let's say we're still on my little bits treats page. So maybe if you buy a whole bag of dog food, you get a free collar, for example. So the first one here we have is percentages. Percentages is pretty simple. On the next step here, under value, you can add your 10% discount. And if you see on the right-hand side, summer 10, 10% off entire order for everyone active from today. So another thing you can do under value is apply it to the entire order, apply it to specific collections, or to actually specific products. So if you have a specific product that you're trying to discount that 10%, you can do so by searching for the product here or hitting on browse and showing you the products, the full products that you have here. For specific collections, we've actually set this up for one of our clients where they had the ability to, they wanted to, for any of the discounts to not be applied on sale items. So what we figured out was we created a collection under products that was non-sale items, which is the equivalent to any item that doesn't have sale. So we, anytime that we do the discounts on their store, we gotta make sure that we apply it to specific collections, and we apply it to that one specific collection that's non-sale item. So that way, customers can't use a discount code on already sale items. Now, as far as other options in here, we have minimum requirements. So you can have a purchase amount. So let's say they have to spend $100 in order to apply the summer 10 discount. And, or you can also do minimum quantity of items. So maybe they have to get two of those items in order to get the 10% off. The next thing is customer eligibility. You can do everyone, or maybe let's say you have a boutique store and you have a VIP list of customers. You can do a specific group or cuff of customers as long as you've already created them under the customers tab on the left-hand side over here. And you can just search for that group of customers by typing the name of it or browsing, which is kind of nifty. And you can also do just specific customers. So if you have a handful of customers, or you have one customer in particular that you want to give a 10% discount, you can do so by going to the discount codes and creating something just for that one person. I'm gonna go back and hit on everyone. As far as the last two here, one is usage limits. So you can limit the number of times the discount can be used in total. So let's say you have summer 10, you send a newsletter and you wanna limit to maybe the first 100 people that use that discount code. After that, you're done, which is kind of cool to create, incentivize people to go ahead and use that code. You can also limit one per customer, which I highly recommend, just so it doesn't get abused by your clients and your customers. Another thing we have here at the very bottom, or the last thing, is the active date. So you can set up to where the coupon starts. And if, for example, summer 10, let's say that you want to end it by the end of summer, you can do so automatically. The coupon code, it won't be allowed to be used after the set date that you have there on the store. Now, that's basically it for discount codes. You can get pretty creative here, especially changing the type. So we went through the percentage type. There's also the fixed amount. If we click on fixed amount, you see here under value, it gives you the ability to maybe $10. And it does so on the summary as well. You can also do just free shipping. And when you click on free shipping, the value changes. And then it gives you the opportunity to do all countries or maybe selected countries. Maybe there are some countries that you don't want to necessarily have a free shipping option because of being very far away. And then you have the other option that we talked about, which is newer, is the buy X, get Y. So when a customer buys X amount of product, customer gets X amount of product. And it actually gives you a few options in here as far as like quantity, if there are any specific products or collections, and then also gives you the ability to do either percentage or the free product. So earlier I talked about buying the full bag of dog food and then getting a free collar. You can do a full bag of dog food and maybe getting the collar at a 10% discount, for example. So that's all possible to do within the discount codes. Now, that's about it on the discount codes. Now, I'm going to go click cancel on here. And when I go back to the automatic discounts, I'm going to show you one use case that we've done this for, and it's wholesale pricing. So we have a bookstore. They only sell one book. And we wanted the ability to, once they reach 10 books in their cart, to switch to wholesale pricing. So the way to do that will be to do it through automatic discounts. So automated discounts, we can do wholesale pricing. And then we want to get rid of, let's say $10. The book is $20. Let's get rid of $10 once they reach a quantity of 10 on the checkout page, on the cart, sorry. So we can do fixed amount and we want to do $10. And then we want to do specific products. So maybe there's that one book in particular, but I think I only have dog treats in here. So search for the dog treats. Let's do the pumpkin buns. And since they're $8, I'm just going to do half of it. So I'm going to do four. So I'm going to change the discount value to four. And then I want to uncheck this one. Only apply discount once per order, because we want to make sure that once it reaches 10, it actually discounts every item in the cart. So we uncheck that. And then what we want to click on here on the minimum requirements is the minimum quantity of items, right? So once they reach 10, then apply the essentially half off for each of those items. So we have the summary over here, wholesale pricing, $4 off the pumpkin bones, and applies to each eligible item per order. And then you have to have 10 of those items in your cart in order to apply that discount. Now, this is kind of cool because the automatic discounts, the user doesn't need an actual code to insert. Shopify automatically takes care of doing the discount as far as that they meet that criteria of the 10 items in the cart. And it has to be not just 10 items, it has to be 10 of the pumpkin bones in order to get the half off, which is kind of cool. All right, and that's it. That's the way you create regular discount codes and automatic discount codes on Shopify. If you like this tutorial on how to add discount codes on Shopify, please leave a like and make sure to subscribe, because we're going to be releasing more Shopify tutorials in the future. And if you have any additional questions, just make sure to leave a comment down below and let us know so we can help you.